You'll be impressed by how easy it is to get people subscribed to your mailing list in your chatbot. In most cases, the user's name and email address will be auto-populated, and what they need to do is just a few taps and it's done. Having a Mailchimp signup form in my chatbot is one of the best decisions I've made for that month. It performed way better than I expected, so I highly suggest that you implement it after completing this section. Let's get started. We will start with chat field. Go to your bot automate section. Create a new group called Mailchimp. Add a block and name it Mailchimp as well. After that, insert a typing action and then the user email plugin. I will replace the text to a shorter message. You can leave it as it is. Save the email to user email attributes. After that, add a JSON API plugin. We will get the URL from Integromat later on. For the user attributes that will be sent to Integromat, put in user email, first name, and last name. For me, I would like to get notified via email that someone has subscribed to my mailing list in my chatbot. So usually at the end of the flow, I will add a send email plugin just to inform me that I have a new subscriber for my chatbot. To do that, add a send email plugin. For the email subject title, I will just put new subscriber demo bot. Then display the user email. Send this notification to my email. For the email content, will be just the name and the email address. Let me just add a new line in between. Next, we create another block and name it invalid email. This is to display a message to the user when the email they type in is invalid. Add a typing action and a simple text card saying your email address is invalid. Provide a quick reply for your user to try again. Now let's go to Integromat. Create a new scenario. Search for chat field. And select JSON listener. Add a new webhook. I will name it Mailchimp. Copy the URL. Go back to chat field. Make sure the type is post. Then paste the URL. Now let's go to setup AI. Add a new AI rule. The keyword will be Mailchimp. And direct user to the Mailchimp block. And then go to automate section. Next, head back to Integromat. Click OK and run the scenario once to send the user attributes over. Once the user attribute has been sent over, I will rename the scenario to Mailchimp. Go to the shortcut tools and select Flow Control. Choose Router and connect the router to the Chat Fields module. Then click on the router to display the two routes. The first route will direct to Mailchimp module. So let's search for Mailchimp and select the action Add or Update a Subscriber. Add a new connection if this is your first time. After that, select a list in your Mailchimp account. Now we will map over the user attributes from ChatFields module. The status should be subscribed by default. Click OK to continue. For the other route, we will direct to ChatFields module. Select JSON respond. Add an item below direct to block. Block name will be invalid email that we have just created in ChatField. Add the item and click OK to continue. Align the modules and set up a filter in route 1. Label valid email. For the condition, select user email attributes. Matches pattern. Now you will need to insert a regular expression which you can get it from Integromat's blog article. I've copied down the regular expression. You can get this document in the resources section. Highlight and copy the regular expression. And then paste it here. Click OK, then set up a filter for the second route. Type in invalid email for the label. Condition, select the user email attribute. This time around, select does not match pattern. Paste the same regular expression here. Click OK when you're done and save. After that, turn on the scenario and run the scenario immediately. Now let's test the bot. Type in Mailchimp to trigger the Mailchimp block. And to test the invalid email, I will just type in 1234. So the filter works, it returns the invalid email block. Let's try again. I will type in my email, which is jh@jinhoe.com. Oops, there's an error message. Sometimes when Integromat don't have a response back to chat field, you will see this error message. But the scenario is working properly. Let me refresh the browser. And you can see that my email has been added in. To fix this, just go to ChatFuel JSON's API plugin and uncheck this option. Now you shouldn't see the error message. In the next lesson, we will send a response back to user to inform them that they have subscribed to our mailing list, and also to inform them if the email already existed in the mailing list. Thank you for watching, I will see you in the next lesson.